Marijuana is legal in some form in most states. However, it's still a federal crime in America. Here's why. As part of the War on Drugs, the Controlled Substances Act was passed in 1971. Drugs were grouped into five schedules based on their medical use, potential for abuse, and dependence liability. How easy it is to get hooked. Marijuana fell into the most serious, Schedule 1, along with heroin, LSD, and ecstasy. However, the anti-marijuana movement began long before that. The anti-weed propaganda began with Mexican immigrants in Texas border towns who were largely associated with the drug despite no evidence that they were using the drug. As the popularity of marijuana grew, so did racist attitudes towards brown people. The Marijuana Act of 1937 banned the use of marijuana federally despite objections from the American Medical Association. After Congress passed the Controlled Substances Act, the DEA classified marijuana as a Schedule 1 substance after the FDA determined it to have no medical use in the U.S.
By getting the public to associate the hippies with marijuana and the blacks with heroin, and then criminalizing both heavily, we could disrupt those communities.
That's what Nixon's top aide, John Ehrlichman, was found saying. In other words, the Controlled Substances Act was a tactic to target Nixon's biggest opposition groups. Despite recent state laws decriminalizing and legalizing marijuana, the Controlled Substances Act is still the law of the land nationally. If federal authorities want to nab you for breaking its weed laws, there are consequences. The MORE Act could change things, though. It would remove marijuana from the Controlled Substances Act and expunge some pot-related criminal records. But it would need to pass Congress in order to become law of the land.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you like this video, check out these other videos from USA Today to stay up to date with all the latest news.